Antibiotic-resistant germs killed more than 1 million people worldwide in 2019 alone and contributed to nearly 5 million additional deaths. Hospitals bathe patients with a special kind of antiseptic soap to prevent infections and tackle antibiotic overuse. It's called chlorhexidine. Chlorhexidine protects patients by wiping bacteria off their skin and stopping possible infections before they even start. Right now, this antiseptic is effective at killing bacteria, but research shows we may potentially need a higher concentration to kill germs. And the bacteria that are more difficult to kill with chlorhexidine are also resistant to antibiotics. Let's make sure one of our top defenses against these infections isn't failing by taking a microscopic dive into chlorhexidine to figure out how to keep it effective and keep our patients healthy.
When you're potentially being exposed to these resistant organisms, and that is potentially leading to what we call a hospital-acquired or healthcare-associated infection, it makes whatever you started with worse.
We'll start by getting samples from patients with various levels of chlorhexidine exposure. Then we'll compare them to surface samples from those patients' rooms. If we see bacteria that are more tolerant to chlorhexidine in the environment, will we find them in our patients as well?
Do we need to be using it less in some populations? Do we need to be using it in a slightly different way? And so we're hoping that this work will provide us with some information that will allow us to use the chlorhexidine more precisely to, again, achieve our goal of reducing infections without increasing the original problem, which is the antibiotic resistance.
Understanding the tolerance that can be developed is very important because otherwise, CHG is not going to be useful.
What we uncover may change how we protect our patients from infections in the future, saving trillions of dollars and millions of lives.